Hey everybody, welcome to my channel. Today I'm going to show you how to make a small hydroponic system to speed up your seedling. Now this is one of my cross and it's been grown here for a few weeks, but I'm going to actually put this into a hydroponic system later, and I wanted to speed it up so that I could get new fruits faster. So I'm going to transfer this to a hydroponic system, a small one for now. Then once it develops enough roots, then I'll transfer that into a larger system. The small hydroponic system is a water bottle system that I've shown in many other videos. So basically what you need is a water bottle like this, any kind, that has an hourglass. And all you need to do is cut this right here under the label. So you can just use some scissors. And that is your bottle here, and a 2-inch net cup, which is fit just like that. And it looks like it's floating, so where this is where the nutrients will go. And at the bottom of the net cup, I kind of cut some of these pieces off to allow a larger gap so that I can feed the roots through. And another item you will need is a rock wool. And this is just a standard rock wool. And it just fits right in here, just like so. And then I use this little beer holder, and all that does is it holds the bottle in place to sort of like prevent lights from getting through. So very simple things. I got this when I was on vacation, but these are very, I think everybody that has the light beer will probably have one of this. And so the system is gonna look like that. So, and then the plant would be in here, and then that would go in there. So first what we'll do is we'll remove this out of here. Okay, to remove the plant, do it however you like, but I always use some kind of utensil, a fork or a spoon or anything like that. You can even just pour the soil out and then remove the plant that way. Alright, here we go. I got it all removed and rinsed off the roots. So we're ready to put this into our unit. So what we'll do here is we'll have our rock wool here. And you can just split this in half. You can use scissors. You can use hand if you don't have it. And this is what it's going to look like. So we'll feed our plant through there. You kind of want the root mostly at the bottom, but you also want some of the plant at the top exposed. This should be good right there. And then we'll carefully feed that through here. And that's what the gap that I made is for, so you can feed the roots through easily. So at this stage, it's very important to keep the roots intact and not damaged. The roots will be hanging like that. And then you'll put it into here. Like so. And you see how the roots is hanging? So we'll add our nutrients. You can use any nutrients you like. This one here is my Arrow Garden nutrients that I mix for my other plants. So I'll just pour it a little in here. You see, this is just slightly touching the roots at the bottom. So that's all you need for now until the plants get adjusted. So as long as the rock wool is nice and moist and the bottom of the roots is touching the water nutrients, that should be good. And then we'll put it into this unit here, like so, very neat and compact. So you need to put this somewhere where there's plenty of lights, because these peppers do need 8 to 10 hours of lights to grow well. So let me show you where we'll put it. Okay, this is where it's gonna go. It's sitting under this LED lights here. And that's what it's gonna look like. And this guy here was once exactly like that. I did the same thing to it. And when it grew large enough, I just placed it into my hydro system. And you can use any hydro system you like, DIY, you can buy your own, or you can put it into the Aero Garden. So that's how easy it is to assist this plant to grow quickly in hydro. So today's May 9th, so I will come back once there is some progress and I will update you guys. Alright guys, it has been exactly 1 week. Today is May 16th and this plant is growing very nicely. So it's making lots of progress. So let me show you the root system. Look at that. There's much more roots here. And there is started to sprout some new ones. So what we're gonna do today is actually remove that one and put this one in its place. And that is my propagated sriracha plant, but I think I'm gonna take this out and put it somewhere else. I want the same variety in this system, so that's why I'm gonna move it. Let's see how much it has grown since it's been in here. Wow, look at that. That's just from a propagated branch. We'll just move this somewhere else and then we'll put this younger one in its place. So I'll remove it out of here. See, it has a really nice root system there. And I need to remove some of this, make it smaller. That should be enough, and then we'll just force it in there. Okay, so there it is. It's gonna be sitting there for a while and grow along with this plant here. That one's making such good progress. So these two are the same variety. It's one of my crosses. So we'll come back later and when these make more progress and I will update you guys. So we'll be back soon. Alright guys, it has been 17 days in total so far and it's looking really really nice. The plant is growing very well and let me show you the other plant. Look at this one, it's just growing like crazy. So these two are the same variety and I placed that one there first, and I mean as soon as the plant established roots, it's just gonna take off like crazy. So this one here just started establishing roots, so in my next update you're gonna see that it's gonna take off really fast. Now, the one thing that you should sort of note is that when you grow plants in the same system, the larger plants will basically take all of the nutrients from the little one because it'll send out roots everywhere and it will take up everything first. So the large one will always remain large and the small one will stay small. So if you're gonna do two plants in a system, just be aware that that's gonna happen. But anyway, we'll come back soon and give you another update. Okay guys, it has been exactly 52 days and the plants are looking awesome. It's starting to grow into the larger plant. Look at the size of these things. So I need to take the smaller one out and then take it outside. So I'm gonna transplant that into soil and I'll leave the larger one here. And the larger one here has tons and tons of flowers and have a few fruits. There's one right there. I crossed it. And there's one right there. So this is a very interesting hybrid that I've been working on, both of them. So let me go ahead and pull the little one out and then we're gonna take this outside and we're gonna transplant that into soil. Okay, I just wanted to show you guys what it looked like when I pull it out. So check out the size of these roots here. It's very, very long. The plant is looking pretty nice. And let me show you the roots.
So look at this, look how long that is. And the plant is not too big, but has a really nice and thick stalk. I've been trimming some leaves and stuff to allow the bottom growth to grow. And here's the top of it, looking pretty nice. And let me show you the larger plant. Look at that, very nice and bushy, looking good. So I'll cover up that space there and then take the smaller plants outside. So let's go ahead and do that right now. All right, here it is. It's been transplanted outside and it's looking pretty nice. It's larger than I thought. So there you have it, guys. If you have a small plant that isn't grown too well, take it and put it into hydroponic, boost its growth, and then you can transfer it outside. And when you transplant this outside, you want to have the water, the soil, sort of like more wet than usual. So it should be really, really nice and moist, but on the wet side, and then keep it out of the sun for a few days, or maybe even up to a week. So give it some good shade, because these leaves are pretty tender and they need to get adjusted to soil and all that stuff. So keep this in the shade for a week and allow it to come back. And once it get adjusted and all that, and then you can slowly expose it to more sun and it will start growing and producing for you. So let me show you a few that I've done already. This here was once in hydroponic and I transplanted that outside, and it's all adjusted now, and it can stay in full sun all day long and it's starting to pot up. Let me show you some of the nice looking pods here. Look at this crazy looking pod. And there's some more. Look at this one, very nice and pretty. Few more here. So that's the one I did, and let me show you another. This one here is also a hydroponic plant. This one is actually the parent of the one that I just showed you. The other one was just a cutting. I cut off of this plant, put it into hydroponic, let it root, and then took it outside. Check out some of the fruits here. Look at this. Let me show you some crazier one. Look at this one here, look at this hook. Man, that's crazy looking. And there's another one there. And this hook right here. So let me show you another one. This one as well. This one was hydroponic. And look how large it is now. Very nice and beautiful. Okay, back to this plant. So as you can see, if you have a few plants that aren't growing at all, or just doesn't seem to grow as fast as you would like, just try the same method. Take it out of soil, put it into hydroponic, allow it to grow, develop roots, and once it's all large, you can take it outside, put it into soil, train the roots to get adjusted to the dirt, and then you have large plants that will just grow really nice for you. Anyway, that is all for this video. I hope you enjoyed. If you have any questions or comments, please leave it below, and thank you so much for watching.